Drake Sterling with IndianaRunner.com. We're here with Futsum Zeinasellassie, a North Central senior who was recently crowned three-time state champ, one of only three people to ever do that in the state of Indiana. Futsum, first of all, congratulations on another state championship, and as well as the new course record for high schoolers, which was set just last year by Lucas Versbikas. I know you ran 14:48, so congratulations on that.
Thank you.
First question, or first thing we'll get to here is, obviously, the point of this interview is to kind of let people know that you will be running NXN this year. Is that correct?
Well, God willing, I would do, Nike and Foot Locker.
Awesome. So you're doing Nike and Foot Locker. So tell me, since we'll start with Nike here, the Laverne Gibson course there in Terre Haute, you've got some experience on that. Tell me what you think about that course and what you like about it, what you don't like about it, how maybe that your experience on it will help you. And let me know about that.
Well, about that course, I mean, it doesn't matter if it's new to you or you've been running for a long time. It's just the same way, you know? I mean, when it's new to you, you don't know what to expect, and you just learn this whole different course. I mean, it's really a hard course, but I mean, if you've been running on it for a while, it's the same thing because you know what's going to come, you know? So, I mean, I don't think it would help running that course a bunch of times or you just running it, you know? Because it's a hard course, you know? It's one of the difficult courses I ever run in Indiana, you know?
Yeah. So I know last week you made the post-race comment that maybe you went out a little bit too fast. I think you were maybe 2:43 through your first K, which I don't think you want to go out quite that fast. Tell us a little bit about how that race went and what you think you could do differently to maybe go after that all-time state record of 14:42.
Well, I mean, first I never went out that fast in any of my races that I remember. 2:43, you know. And I was gonna have a watch and just run through it, but I know it would not be cool, you know. So I just took my watch off and gave one of my teammates and to hold the time for me, you know. But going the first K, because it's usually it's fast, you can't really control yourself, you know. You just run all out till you feel that pain, you know. So I went out too fast, but I don't think I could have done any different to improve my time. I think just having a competition or somebody to push you up there with you, it would make different, you know. But just me running the whole course again, and I don't think it would make any different going out fast or slow, you know. It's all about the competition. If you have somebody to push you through the race, you would probably go a little faster, I guess.
Okay. You play forgiveness, watch it now, here he comes. What made you decide to do NXN this year? I know you hadn't done it in past years. What decided to make you do the double this year, which is the same double that Lucas did last year?
Well, I don't know. I mean, at first it's just to try some new thing, and second, when I did the Foot Locker, there were a couple guys like Elias Gidon, Craig Lott, a bunch of guys that, great high school runners, you know, in the USA. So, but I didn't have the chance to race them in cross country, you know, and I just want to test myself in both of them and see how well I could do. I mean, I think I was ranking second or second. Well, I got second at the Foot Locker race, but because I didn't run Nike, it just I don't really know how good I were, and you know. Mm-hmm. So this year I just want to do both of them and see how well I could do in both races, you know.
Okay. Well, obviously there's something a little bit different about the NXN race, which is the hay bales. Mm-hmm. So have you ever experienced anything like that? Have you ever had any obstacles in a race, or what do you expect from that?
No, I've never done any like that, you know, but it's a new thing, you know, and I think we're getting some of those, couple of those this week, and practice on them, you know.
Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be a good interview if I didn't ask you about your competition, which most notably will be Edward Chesrick. We have information that there's a good chance he might be running NXN as well as Foot Locker. We're not sure. I know the qualifier's on the same day, so it's going to be one or the other. But leading up to that matchup that could happen either at Portland or San Diego, what do you think about him, and how do you think going into a race, probably for the first time this year, you'll actually maybe be an underdog? And how do you think that'll go out for you?
First, I'm not just racing Chesbrook, you know. I'm racing everyone who's running the Nike final or the Foot Locker final, you know. But Chesbrook is a great runner. He's a good runner, and he's been running fast times, you know. But I don't know, or the ranking or the time, that doesn't really matter. What matters is who bring the game on during the race, you know. So I'm really excited to race against the Chesbrook, all the other high school runners, you know. I can't wait.
Mm-hmm. How's your training been different this season than in past years? I know that, you know, you're going, a lot of kids don't have the opportunity to run in these late November meets like Foot Locker NXN. So what do you do different? How has your training been different this year? Because you've been a force this year, you're undefeated, you're running great. So you got to be confident going in.
Well, I mean, I don't think there is a bunch of stuff that I did different this year, but it just doing the same training over and over the years, I think it kind of made me a better runner and made me stronger, I guess. And running those 5Ks for a long time, it's just it became normal, you know. So, but there's nothing I have done any different, but except I've been holding my mileage a little bit longer. I didn't really tape a lot for the section of original, and I was a little bit sick for summer state, and kind of tape a little bit summer state and state, but and I'm just going back to my normal training till I guess next week and a week after that.
Okay. Well, last question, do you have any tips out there for other runners who are trying to reach that next level, the level where they're trying to run at these postseason meets and qualify for the national meet? If you had to say something to them, what would it be?
For Foot Locker and Nike?
Yeah, anybody who's out there trying to get to, and obviously it's going to be hard to get to your level, but just trying to get to the level of the elites in Indiana as well as the other Midwest states.
Well, the only tip I think I could give is that you gotta run the same mileage you do over and over, you know, to get better. And I know you won't get better in 1 year or in 2 years, you know. It'll take time and hard working, you know. You just gotta do trust your coaches and do what they told you to do, and to just do it over and over the training they give you, you know. And I don't think there's any tips I could give for Foot Locker or Nike.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview. It's an honor having you today. Congratulations to you on another state title, and as well as the North Central Panthers, who had a pretty good season as well. I know you guys didn't run quite as well as you'd probably hoped to at state, but you had a great season nonetheless. So congratulations, and thank you.
Thank you.